Kilpatrick envisaged a line that he called the sensitivity line. And he drew the line through the project duration point. And let's just draw this line through there like that. So we just put an SL up there for the sensitivity line. Now, what is that sensitivity line? Well, it's a mechanism for translating lateness, as shown by the loss of float, into lateness on the project duration. And because the project duration could be in calendar time or working days, the angle of that line could change. In essence, if we have working days along the project duration, therefore working days in the float up there and the days on this axis are the same scale, this is a 45 degree line. It can change if we modify this to be a calendar date. But what happens here when we trend this line is we put a trend through there, and I'll just draw it as a dotted line just to show you, hits this line at that point there. What does that mean? Well, it means this project looks as if it's going to be late, and it's going to be late. If I project a line from there up to the axis there, it's that much late. If I do a similar thing by walking along and looking at the trend from the least urgent work here, the ninth decile, and trend that one, this, of course, now looks as if that's going to be early. Upshot of this is the non-urgent work, usually fairly easy, is being provided with a lot of resources, and it looks like it's going to be finished early. Whereas the difficult stuff, usually on the critical path, is not being done on time and suffers perhaps with a lack of resources, certainly with a lack of progress. And the trend on that one is it looks as if it's going to be running late. This is the most typical thing you find. And this is what happens with the other one. It looks as if it's running late as well. You can see that in that one. So that technique, pretty simple, pretty effective, and it's devastating. It's relentless in the way it monitors, translates the monitoring of the progress into a trend on float against this sensitivity line here, which indicates whether or not we're going to be late or early in various parts of the project. Now, I've used this in dry docks where the work has been done in a 35-day period. I've used it in shutdowns, construction projects, and I have lots of colleagues who've used it in various places in the defense industry, aerospace, oil and gas. Not a great number of people use it, but all the people who've used it are incredibly enthusiastic about it. So what I'd like to do is start other people becoming enthusiastic about it by initially this video, and then perhaps some demonstration in a simple add-in to Microsoft Project.